Denny, last year, what do you have to say right this minute to all the Denny doubters that last year said, well, he didn't win a race, he's not going to win a race, and here you are?
Yeah, it's amazing. I told him over the radio, I've been in this position so many times, I can't believe how many times I've been on the front row on the last restart for the Daytona 500, and I deem myself 1-for-4 in those situations, but I guess now I'm 2-for-5, so amazing job by this whole FedEx team. Got to thank Toyota, everyone that helped put this race car on the racetrack, Coca-Cola, the Jordan brand. Michael Jordan's birthday is today. It's pretty amazing. Everyone at Little Big Burger as well. So just a great day overall for our race team. We got a rookie team here for me. A lot of these guys are brand new, and some of them are still here on this team. But to have all these FedEx executives here, this is just the greatest day.
Yeah, Denny's TW. This the emotion. I mean, I know how emotional I was for Joe Gibbs and for JD and 11 and you're going to donate $111 for every lap you lead and your family's there and your new team, your crew chief. What an incredible win that it was for you.
Yeah, it's just the rebranding of the car as well to bring back the white and the FedEx. It's just one of those days where it just felt like I was meant to be, honestly. Our car was really good. We got a little mixed up there in the middle of the race where we couldn't get the fuel in the car. But other than that, we ran up front all day and put ourselves in great position and just capitalized at the end. And, hats off to Kyle as well. I know he was eagerly wanting his first victory here in the Daytona 500, but, today we just weren't going to be denied.
Hey, Denny, this is Jeff. I want to go back to this last couple of restarts. You talked about your teammate Kyle Busch. You guys had a conversation there with Chris Gabehart, your new crew chief, about what to do on that last restart. You saw where Kyle Busch chose the inside the time before, and you got the lead because of that. This time you had to make a decision, try to figure out how to get in front of him.
When he gave me the top, I literally was doing a little cheer in my mind thinking, my playbook said always choose the top, no matter what, no matter who's behind you, it doesn't matter. That's why I'm saying I've been on the front row so many restarts and lost it because I've been on the bottom, and I just felt like when we got the opportunity to jump up there, obviously there were circumstances that happened behind us that allowed us to be up front at the caution, but felt pretty good about being on the top line there. And then obviously we thought it was best idea for us. He asked about me pulling down in front of him on the final restart, and I was good with that because I thought that between him and the 22, those were going to be the two best pushers, and it worked out well for us.
Well, thank you, Denny. Go celebrate.
Congrats.
I will. I'm going to hate tomorrow, but I'm going to love the rest of my life, I can tell you that.
Enjoy every second.
Thank you.
Hey, NASCAR fans. Thanks for checking out the NBC Sports YouTube channel. Make sure you hit subscribe below for the latest NASCAR news, race highlights, and digital exclusives. Thanks for watching.